James Kaufman, World News Report today. Ladies and gentlemen, we've just had an X5.16 solar flare with a huge coronal mass ejection lifted off the surface of our sun, and it will be a direct hit on Earth. NASA has already put up a model somehow. Never seen them act this quickly. Earth is here in the yellow. These are our satellites surrounding it, and you can see that the main body of the coronal mass ejection looks like it's going to be a direct hit. This is a very fast moving CME, so it very well might catch yesterday's and create a huge cannibal CME. This is a huge problem here. Now, we don't have yesterday's CME on this model, but as you can tell by the timestamp up here, we're looking for an impact on the 13th. Well, that's when yesterday's X1.02 is supposed to impact Earth. If they were to both hit near the same time, we would be facing a horrible cannibal CME situation. Heading over to our GOES X-ray flux, these are the three X flares we're dealing with. This is the 5.16 solar flare that just popped off. We haven't seen anything that powerful in quite a while. It has caused a huge proton storm, unlike one I don't remember. And I know that Earth shields are nothing compared to what they were years ago. So we're going to see what happens here. The real problem is this CME here is going to be much slower moving. The one from yesterday was the 1.02, and we still haven't been hit by this CME either. We haven't been hit by any coronal mass ejections. There was supposed to be one before this one that was going to impact us yesterday, which just didn't happen. So we have a huge problem here. Looks like the X flare peaked at around about 10:10, which is going to be about 3:10 in the morning central time here in the U.S. And here we go over to Space Weather Live. We got a 5.16. They did assign it 242.74. Old buddy, the only Delta class sunspot we have on our Earth facing solar disk. Today we had a 35% chance of having an X class solar flare, which is as high as I've ever seen. We might have another one. A 75% chance of having an M class solar flare. It looks like we've had a few of those, an M15 and M14, and we've been running a C baseline for a couple of weeks again. We're currently at a C1.29. Now, this flare peaked at 10:04. We were off by 6 minutes there. It wasn't necessarily long term, but it was definitely Earth facing and definitely lifted a lot of plasma, as you could tell by the model, from the solar surface. And it's directly headed at high speeds towards Earth. Again, that problem is going to be a possible cannibal CME with the last two X flares, the X1.02 and the X5.16, arriving at the same or near the same time. Over to HMI and Tensogram, 4274 is the only Delta sunspot we have. We have a beta gamma sunspot down here, 4276. It's like it is becoming more complex, as do 4277 and 4275. And we have three additional simple sunspots, as you can see here. So it looks like altogether we have seven sunspot groups, Earth facing, with additional very powerful sunspots that look like they almost need to be named, that are coming around the limb. Now, y'all are used to seeing geomagnetic storms. This is a proton storm, also known as an solar storm, i.e. one of the S's. And I'll show you exactly what that means. We hardly ever see them. That's the only reason you should be using the word solar storm, is when you have a proton storm that breaks the space weather threshold. Now, let me explain this to you because it's scary. We've had the 10 million volts of electricity break through our atmosphere. In blue, we've also had the 50 million volts of electricity break through. And believe it or not, in green, we've had the 100 million volts of electricity break through the atmospheric barrier or the space weather threshold. And, well, we even were able to get the 500 million volts of electricity almost there. I've never seen the thing move at all. This is incredible. You won't believe what LASCO looks like. And over our GOES solar ultraviolet imager, 195 angstroms. This is the ongoing event here. It almost looks like it's flared again. I wouldn't doubt that it might spurt out a second X-flare today. It's like we have a coronal hole on top of all that that's forming right here. And it looks like we have several, at least three sunspots coming around the limb that need to be named. And like I said, the sunspots down here both look like they're becoming much more complex. This is worst case scenario. Again, the difference between now and 2003 is that we have no atmosphere or shields. We have huge holes, complete missing atmosphere in several places around the globe. This is bad news. And this is how you know you've gotten hit. Lots of missing time. You'll see the flare pop off, and then the protons themselves hitting our GOES camera. Wow. It's been a while. Remember, the 100 million volts is broken through the space weather alert threshold, along with the 10 million volts and the 50 million volts. We almost had the 500 million volts breakthrough, which I don't know if that's ever occurred. I would have to look back, but I don't know if it's ever occurred. So there you can see on LASCO C3, we're in a real proton storm now. Much, much more intense than anything we've seen. There's the explosion there, lots of missing time, and the protons start almost immediately. Wow. All right, we were already in a polar cap absorption event, and here comes that X flare right over Africa. It almost pops off over the same area each day. I wonder if something's going on that's, well, being helped out by man. Look at the polar cap absorption event. Look at the radio alternation. Someone tried to tell me that this was good for Earth yesterday in one of the forums. Well, they was laughing, move on. Yes, it's great that we're being bombarded with X-rays and protons. Since we're electrical beings, it's fabulous. Obviously, this is a lot of radiation, folks. More so than we would ever want. It sneaks in the holes in between our Van Allen belts that we have in the, there it is, in the South Pole and in the North Pole. So that's where it sneaks in, and that's why the poles light up red. That's where the concentration of protons and X-rays end up, although the whole globe is just getting fried. One last peek at the, well, impact site. I will say that I've never seen NASA model anything this quickly, even close. It looks like this thing might be moving at over 2 million kilometers per second, which means it's going to catch the other X-flare, which means we're looking at a huge possible cannibal CME 1, 2, 3, because we still haven't seen the first impact from the first X flare either. This could be, well, a triplet to remember, or at least a Cannibal CME, a 1-2 punch with yesterday's 1.02 and today's 5.16 X flares hitting at almost or at the same time. Quick look at STO HMI. The main reason I wanted y'all to see that is there's our very active 4274. These are the two other sunspots. I told you look like they're trying to become complex. And you can barely see a couple of these sunspots coming around the limb here that haven't been named yet, but we'll start to, well, be in play here very soon. So nothing's letting up, and we're headed for that 19th, 20th, 21st alignment that I've been talking about. Over on SOHO, 284 angstroms, you can see those sunspots coming around the limb a lot better. You can see the two sunspots here that are becoming more complex. The coronal hole that's formed here, and of course 4274, which is absolutely enormous. I know we haven't seen any impacts. Technically, we're waiting on 4, but I'm thinking that NASA blew the M flare and it's not going to hit us. That means we're waiting on the 3 X flares. Then they should start impacting Earth later today at some point into tomorrow. The first one maybe later today into tomorrow, and the next two on the 12th and 13th, somewhere in there. Depending on the speeds, which I know that they're going to have to wait for these things to hit Discover to get some real speeds, which is only 1 million miles from Earth, the Sun being 93.3 million miles from Earth. So we have some time to wait to find out what kind of speed we're looking at here. But by the time it does hit Lagrange Point 1, Discover and ACE satellites, we're only talking about having 15 minutes, perhaps, of warning time. Now, you know me, I went ahead and checked to make sure that we weren't getting hit. The good thing we see here is our shields are up, just slightly above the line here in red. And we can see that our angle is north in blue. But we have very light solar winds, very light plasma, and temperatures are up and down, normal. Nothing's hit our Discover satellite whatsoever. Again, we're waiting on the 3 X flares. Both of them have been modeled to hit Earth directly. We'll quickly check our work on ACE real-time space weather satellite. This is the predecessor of Discover. Can see the temperatures are really varying all over the place, from extremely low to just above normal. So that is kind of weird. Solar winds are down right above 400 kilometers per second. Plasma is at about 2 centimeters cubed. Our angle is very, very high. I like that. And our BZ shields just came up above the zero line here. We pray that they stay that way, but the chances are little to none, especially with all of the protons impacting the shields now. And that's going to be ongoing. So with that said, one more recap here. The Sun has just delivered a huge X5.16 solar flare and lifted a very large coronal mass ejection from the solar disk. It's headed directly towards Earth at very high speeds. It could catch yesterday's X flare, then become a Cannibal X flare. We also have another X flare that's going to hit between now and then. Now and then looks like, based on their modeling, around the 12th to 13th. I can catch it here, about the 12th to 13th. It's really, really hard to determine. It really matters this time. because we have the other X flare, or both the other X flares, inbound before this one. I wish they would have put all three on the model, but there's probably not much room in between Earth and the Sun based on how fast this particular third X flare is moving. Again, I'm guessing upwards of 2 million miles an hour, which is going to put it here very, very quickly. With that said, God bless each and every one of you guys. Please put your tinfoil hats on for fun, right? I'll do a tinfoil hat experiment live here today, and line your baseball cap with a tinfoil hat. Maybe you'll remember your name and remember your language and all the things you've learned over your life if we were to be hit by a huge, uncontrolled solar explosion. God bless you guys. Share, subscribe, and always remember that anything's possible in Bizarro World. And please, please help support the channel via Super Chat, Super Thanks, and or buying us a cup of coffee. Find the link in the chat and in the description. Thank you, and God bless you.